I talk stupid talk. I eat disgusting bird. When, oh when, will I get to see precious teeth?
I'm a vegetarian. I'll just drink the water.
Very well, but it's beef water, dear. It was just a joke. Midge, tell her.
The very wealthy do that, Mrs. Izumi. You'll catch on.
Now, I'm a somewhat adventurous eater. Of most things, I'll try a smidgen. But mark my words, good people, I will not eat this old pigeon.
I'm watching my girlish figure.
The pigeon is divine.
Whoever said the pigeon was a worthless bird never tried eating it in an Alfredo Vindolo sauce.
Now, Flip, you won't get your pigeon until you finish your liver.
Yes, you're the only one still on appetizers, Flip. Step it up a bit.
I'm just savoring every last bite. I'd sooner drink llama bean juice than eat some poor thing's liver. It's barbaric.
Someday I'll learn to enjoy the vile delicacies upon which the financially superior feast.
I'm watching her girlish figure. All the good things from Greece rolled into a salad.
I hand-baked these desserts myself 3 months in advance. They may be a little hard by now, but not to worry. If you chip a tooth, I know a sensational dentist.
A cookie a day keeps the doctor away. I just thought I'd drop in.
Are you the god of wind?
No.
Then we're not interested.
I'm praying for wind to help us sail, or food to help feed us, or else maybe dancing priests to help distract us.
That's an odd request.
Didn't you meet any bises ashore? Their presence is important at many events. To ensure fertility, they dance themselves into delirium, often inflicting injury to show how entranced they are.
Funny, where I'm from, to ensure fertility, we just use manure. Go like this. You've got a boogies. You aren't by any chance the carriers of the human soul.
Nope. We're the boogies.
The fierce boogies.
Gypsy sea traders and navigators of even the most ferocious monsoon. Needless to say, it takes a little wind to make a good monsoon.
Boogies, huh? When I was little, I used to hear stories about boogies. Boogeymen.
That's us.
But the boogeymen were supposed to be horrible. Why would that be based on you, boogies? May I call you boogies? Is that politically correct?
Our forefathers were ferocious pirates who looted goods and cargo, doing away with anyone who stood in their way.
Oh, well, that makes sense then.
Several months ago, a neighboring boogies tribe, much like this one, attacked a boat for goods, killed everyone aboard.
That wasn't very nice of the neighboring boogies tribe.
Yes, well, in retrospect, they're sorry.
Hi, I'm a banded sea snake. I have enough venom in my body to knock out 70 grown men. I'm the most poisonous snake in the world. Ha ha ha!
Epitaph for a dying shark. Perhaps my sorrow would not be as great if my entire sharkhood were on man's dinner plate. But to wound a great shark, not for meat, not for skins, but for only an item as small as his fins. It dishonors the code which the food chain hath writ. If only I had strength, sure, I'd pitch a huge fit.
How tragic. Great shark, I promise I'll get your fins back for you, or my name isn't Pink Panther.
Much obliged, Pink Panther.
Never know when a barnacle will come in handy. Say, you boogies, I think there's enough here for everyone.
Lucky for you. Barnacles would make a great soup when you haven't eaten. Delicious. Best barnacles I ever tasted.
Never know when a burlap sack will come in handy. And now that the soup is ready and the barnacles are nice and warm, maybe they won't notice if I pocket some shark fins.
Delicious.
There's an old Irish proverb that says, there's hope from the sea, but none from the grave. Hope this venomous snake won't chomp a pink knave.
Just as you'd promised, I am an able shark again. Free to devour sea creatures whole and play my vital role in the food chain. It's my job, you know. Perhaps I'll become a vegan. You know, one of those people who won't eat dairy.
Or maybe you can help me now. I'm stuck on that sailboat and there's no wind. Perhaps you could give me a lift?
I'm a changed fish with a big heart. I'll be glad to help you.
Yikes! That moray eel looks hungry. Those sharp teeth are frightening. Maybe I should offer him a delicious snack food so he won't snack on me.
What you got?
Baked goods?
Sounds scrumptidlyicious. Hey, I lost a tooth!
Sorry, Charlie.
Do you know how expensive dental work is down here underwater?
To Dragon Island! As you wish.
From my book of knowledge.
You better get out of here. Save yourself, you hear me? Unless you want to get eaten by one of those disgusting dragons. I hate dragons.
The sign says all the dragons are that way.
Only the ones who are looking for a handout from the tourists. The dragons roam free all over this island.
It's a tourist trap.
Oh no, it's over. Titans for me! You'll never get this ham sandwich!
Little pig!
Let me live?
Not by the toxic saliva on my flickering yellow tongue!
What are you doing?
I'm getting ready to have a ham sandwich, you fool. Now get lost.
You know, the tourists are giving out dead goats over there just because they want to watch us feed. Sure is a lot easier than chasing around some nervous ham sandwich.
I am not like you domesticated sellouts. I am a fierce female dragon capable of laying 30 eggs in one sitting. I enjoy the hunt of my prey, and in case you forgot, Komodo dragons are also cannibals. Now scram before I devour you. Now, where was I?
Excuse me, Linda, the Komodo dragon?
Oh, so you're a tourist.
How did you know?
Because the locals call Komodo dragons Aura.
Okay, Aura then. I was just wondering, is there any way I can save that little pig?
I wish I had something that would scare her away.
I'm afraid of spiders and snakes, and of course, giant rats, and the dark, and boogeyman, and, did I mention snakes? I am really scared of snakes.
Run away, retreat!
Was it something I said?
That was a close call. Thanks a lot. Here, allow me to say thanks.
What's this?
What do you think? It's the coveted ham sandwich.
Wow. Thanks a lot.
Hey, it's no skin off my back.
I thought it was... Never mind. Some view.
To the jungles of Borneo!
An orangutan, an anthropoid. The orangutan is an endangered species. There are only 5,000 of us left living in the wild. Orangutan means man of the jungle.
I don't suppose you're the... Never mind.
Hi, I'm a tiny tarsier. I'm a nocturnal prosimian with big old eyes that I can't move around. But not to worry, I can swivel my head 180 degrees so I see everything that's coming or going.
Are you the carrier of the human soul?
No, I'm a tiny tarsier. Are you listening or what?
When you gotta go, you gotta go. I wonder what this means. Oh, hello.
You found our message stick. Let me teach you how to read it. These curls indicate that there are four of us traveling. These shapes say that we've been traveling for 2 moons, 2 months. Any dyad, as they call us, knows how to read this.
You sure do have a lot of body art.
It is a Dayak tradition to mark every important event with a tattoo.
My mom would freak. I wasn't even allowed to get my ear pierced. You wouldn't be the carrier of the human soul by any chance?
Do I look like a hornbill to you? My people believe that it is the legendary hornbill that is the carrier of the human soul, the most sacred of birds.
Something must have happened to the husband. He's not been back to the tree. We have been pushing food to them through the crack when they let us, but the hornbill must break open the nest for itself from the inside. They've not seen his beak pushing through the hole, so they are afraid to come out.
I am too weak to walk. I am starving. It has been days since I've eaten.
Would you be interested in a ham? I think there are birds sealed in that tree.
He seals up the nest with clay, leaving an opening the exact dimensions of a hornbill beak.
This is another page from my book of knowledge.
Just
just a few moments, we'll climb into the basket and turn the burners on high. We will then slowly drift into the sky, where we will begin our journey over the Masai Mara National Reserve toward Lake Victoria. Lake Victoria is the world's second largest freshwater lake. It is second only to Lake Superior, which, needless to say, is superior. Oh, foo! We lost the lever that turns a burner on. I need something to replace it. No, this is not good news, folks. Since you're not in the basket, could you do something to replace the handle?